Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Like I mentioned in my previous video, today will be my first glass painting video. I don't know if you guys saw that short I did recently. That was just a practice attempt. You know, really liked how it turned out. Took me quite a bit though. So today I chose something a little bit simpler. Today's glass painting is gonna consist of me painting the Straw Hat Pirate logo from One Piece. This is what it looks like. I chose this because it's gonna be pretty easy. There's only four colors, black, white, red, and whatever his hat color is. I am colorblind, so if I mess up on any colors in any of these videos, I apologize. I struggle with it. I do the best I can. I've spent many hours in the aisles of Hobby Lobby with my girlfriend helping me pick out colors. Yeah, I'm sure I'll mess up at some point. Four colors are black, white, I used crimson red, and I used something called yellow ochre. I probably said that wrong. I've actually already recorded me painting the actual piece. I did talk a lot at the beginning of it, so I'll let that play. But after that initial part, I don't talk as much. Or I think what I'm gonna do is just like a voiceover of, you know, certain parts of it. You know, I'll commentate on points that I messed up on, my thought process on certain parts of it. And I think I'm also gonna go through each Straw Hat Pirate individually and just give a very vague reason why I like them. You know, I'm gonna try and keep it spoiler free. You know, I wouldn't wanna be spoiled, so I'm not gonna try and spoil you guys. And once I get good enough and I actually start doing my Straw Hat Pirate paintings individually, then I'll probably dive in a little bit more in depth into each character. However, for this video, I'll just keep it pretty concise on each pirate so it's not like 20 minutes long. But yeah, without further ado, let's just get into it.
All right, here's the basis for the painting. I'm gonna outline it all with this fancy paint marker I got. It's just from Hobby Lobby, nothing special by any means. It was like $2. I already cleaned the glass with some alcohol at this point. Next step, I'm going to tape this picture onto the glass so I can outline it and move it around without like messing it up and kind of ruining my original design per se. Got my tape on, hope it's centered. If it's not, you know, it's not that big of a deal. We'll kind of just work with it. Here it is from the front. Usually with glass paintings, you have to like reverse the picture and like flip it around so that when you paint it, it looks like the original design. So luckily with this one, obviously it's not going to matter. So that works in my favor.
As you can see here, I am outlining some more. There are some errors, obviously. But like I said, I'm still new at it, and I was having fun, so I wasn't too concerned with it all. To start with what I like about each Straw Hat, we'll start with the man himself, future king of the pirates, the captain of the Straw Hats, Luffy. And the thing I really love about Luffy is that, like, no matter what, he is absolutely down as hell for his crew. Like, even with only knowing him for a few days, a few hours, or just even a few minutes, he's still like, bro, I'm going to go to bat for you any day of the week, no matter what. There are multiple instances of Luffy, like, literally diving into some of the worst situations in the One Piece world, all just to save one of his crew members. And there's also a certain trait of Luffy whenever the crew is getting the backstory of a potential crew member, he doesn't listen to it. He'll often fall asleep during. I really like it just because it hammers the fact that he really doesn't give a shit about what kind of past they have, you know, what they've done in the past, what crimes they've committed or whatever. All he cares about is they're here now, and whatever they face in the past, you know, they won't have to face it again because he's going to be there with them. Moving on to the right hand man in Luffy is our boy Zoro. Obviously, I love Zoro's design. He has that cool, calm, collected demeanor about him. Every shonen manga or anime always has that one character, and in this show, it's Zoro. He kind of does his own thing on the boat. He doesn't really get involved in many of the antics that the crew has, like between islands and stuff. So I kind of view him as more of a big brother to the crew. You know, he doesn't show it very well, but he really does care for them like his own family. And it'll show him like training an exorbitant amount, all just so that he can protect them no matter what.
He doesn't want anything to happen to them because he loves them, but he won't tell any of them that because that's just not who he is. You know, he's going to love you through his actions rather than his words, and I just think he's awesome for that. Thirdly is Nami. For a while there, I was not very fond of Nami, but she did eventually grow on me as the series progressed. You know, she's like the strongest person on the crew when it comes to disciplining the rest of them. Like, when Luffy and Usopp and Chopper and Zoro or Sanji, they all get in the fight, she's there and she's going to beat the shit out of them to stop it. She is the navigator. Without her, they'd be dead in the water, literally. If I had to make like a ranking list of like the Straw Hats based off how much I like them, she would be on the lower end, but I do think that she is very important to the crew and important to the story, however, and I do think she's awesome. Usopp does get annoying for sure. I mean, even now he gets on my nerves occasionally, and it's all because he's just pretty much scared of everything. However, if you really dive into it and think about it, he is just your ordinary run-of-the-mill dude in a crew with powerhouses who then fight other powerhouses in the world. And so I do think he deserves more love than he gets. However, my absolute favorite thing about Usopp is, like, even though he's, like, scared as shit all the time, and even when he's absolutely terrified in one situation, he will still go above and beyond the best that he can to save his friends. And while saving his friends, he's going to be scared as shit doing it, but I still think that's what makes him a god. On the Sanji. Sanji is amongst the strongest of the crew. He's actually in a trio with Luffy and Zoro called the Monster Trio, coined by fans. However, I don't love Sanji because of his strength. I really like Sanji because early on you find out that Sanji has some like ideals and rules surrounding food. And this all comes from a traumatic event from his childhood, and I think it's really cool when you get to see him uphold and defend those ideals and rules that he set without hesitation when they're challenged by someone or when they get presented to him. You know, he's always throwing himself in harm's way for his crew, ready to sacrifice his own dream so that others can accomplish theirs. He does get annoying with his antics surrounding women, however, regardless of that, I do think Sanji. I am partial to Chopper because of my medical background. I am a nurse. I love Chopper a lot because of the scenes where he is treating people or trying to treat people, and you can just tell that bro straight up gives a shit about his patients. I've experienced a lot of physicians in the past where I do think that their heart lies somewhere else, and in the way they care for the patient shows. And so it's definitely frustrating to see that in real life. And so it's kind of nice to see, even though he's a fictional character, it's just nice to see it done right. He's straight up down as hell to save a life, and I love it. Because 99% of the time, he's an absolute wimp. But, you know, even when he is wimpy, he is cute. However, when it does come time to save someone, you know, via medical treatment or whatever, you better believe that Chopper's fucking here to go. But even though he is a wimp 99% of the time, when it comes down to it and it's time to save someone's life, you better believe Chopper is stepping up without hesitation. And because of that, I absolutely love Chopper. We're on to Robin now. I love Robin a lot. She's also one of my favorites. I will not dive into why I love Robin too much because it involves like heavy spoilers into her backstory and stuff, but I'll avoid that for now. I view Robin as kind of like a big sister slash mother role on the crew. However, one thing that I do really like about Robin is that when she initially joins the crew, she has kind of a wall up and she's very guarded to them all. And she refers to everyone on the crew as their role. Like Luffy is captain, Zoro is swordsman, or Sanji is cook. And as the series progresses and she does start to trust them more and kind of open her heart up to them, that's when she starts calling them their names. And like the first time she does it, it hit me and I was like, whoa. She just said his name. Like, she just said Zoro's name or Luffy's name. And it was just, like, really refreshing to see her kind of have that wall broken down for her. And I just love the transition of her from being guarded because of her past experiences to, like, opening up to this new crew and finding, like, a family out of it. Frankie, from Frankie's introduction, you find out that he has his own family, per se. He's called the Frankie family. This family is pretty much just a bunch of society's rejects, who then he gives a home and a purpose again. I do think Frankie has some really enjoyable fights. I also really enjoy Frankie's fighting style because they're all more technology-based. Dude's out here shooting laser beams. He's a legit cyborg and he fights like it, and I think that's really cool and creative, and I really enjoy seeing how Oda writes his fights, what Frankie's gonna do next with this technology, and just, it's really cool. I do wish Frankie got some more love. There's a couple other people on the Straw Hats who are also in dire need of some love. However, Frankie does have a super cold moment in the Dressrosa arc that I really love. So in the meantime, I'll just patiently wait for some more Frankie moments. Brook is an absolute beast. His introduction brought about the fire song known as Bink's Sake. I have listened to Bink's Sake more times than I am proud to admit, and I will continue to do so because that song is absolutely amazing. The one thing I really love about Brook's devil fruit resurrected him from the dead, and then he spent an extensive amount of time isolated from everyone in the world, unwillingly. And then eventually Luffy's crew finds him and they kind of adopt him into his crew. And very early on, he is always there and he's always willing to throw his life down for the rest of the crew no matter what. There is one scene in particular where Brook is faced with an absolutely impossible opponent for him to beat. And that dude straight up draws a sword and looks at this opponent and he says, "Bring it on, bitch." Brook has already died and went through hell. And even after all that, he's super cheerful and no matter what. And because of that, I think Brook's an absolute beast and I love him. I do wish he got some more love though from Oda, please. Lastly, we are on to Jinbei. Jinbei is awesome because for a long time he wasn't actually a part of the crew. However, despite this, the one thing I do love about Jinbei the most from his early on character introduction is that he was with Luffy in some of the hardest moments in Luffy's life, even when Luffy's own crew couldn't be there. He even saved Luffy from borderline mental collapse at one point and even got him out of a super hellish situation. And through this and some subsequent events, he ends up joining the crew, and I was super pumped to see that, and I'm looking forward to seeing some more Jinbei moments going forward. But yeah, following those awesome pirates, I was planning on doing more commentary with this video. However, I went a little overboard with how much I talked about them, but I love all the characters, so I don't mind it. There were a couple parts in this video where you saw me make a mistake and I was fixing it. My girlfriend actually saw a content creator use a blackhead remover, and so I went ahead and ordered that. So hopefully if I make a mistake going forward, I can fix it a lot easier than trying to rub it with alcohol and messing up a line. And this way I can just kind of chip away at it super easily, super smooth, and hopefully I can make my lines better as well. There are a couple moments in this video where it kind of jumps around quite a bit, like I make a lot of progress really quickly. This took me an entire 4 hours to make just because I put the paint on really thick. And when I was making this, I was also recording videos on my phone so I can make a short version of it as well. And so I kind of cut out moments where I was recording with my phone, and there were times where I recorded quite a bit with my phone. And so there's some kind of gaps in that, and I apologize. I'm still trying to figure out the whole filming thing, kind of new to it, trying to figure out the angles and stuff. But yeah, as this video comes to an end, I really enjoyed this. I hope you guys... I tried to keep it vague, as vague as I could, and kind of give you as accurate as of... Tried to keep it vague, didn't want to spoil anything, did the best I could. Obviously, some of them are more vague than others. You can tell who my favorites are, probably from how much I talked about. Probably my top four is easy. It's... in no particular order, my top four is Luffy, Zoro, Chopper, and Robin. I'd love to know your guys' top three, top four, top five down below if you wouldn't mind. But yeah, coming up on the final reveal here soon, I'll quit talking and let you guys see that.
But yeah, I think it turned out pretty good for the most part. There are a couple parts of it that I wish I would have done a little bit better. My edge work is a little sloppy in areas, and I also have a couple bleed through areas throughout. Those are pretty easy fixes. I could either get a new marker or I could simply hold the painting up to the light, and that'll show me where I need to kind of go back over and, you know, make it darker. But for the most part, I think it turned out pretty good. I am proud of it. I really enjoyed it. It was kind of therapeutic, just kind of sitting back, relaxing, listening to some chill ass music, and then just kind of vibing and painting. I think my next one is gonna be Tuesday, Wednesday next week. That's my goal. That's what I'm gonna try and do. It's gonna be another simple one. It's gonna be the Akatsuki logo from Naruto. If you guys know what that is, it's just a cloud essentially, and it's only consists of like three colors. Black, red, and white. I'm gonna try and keep them pretty simple at the start so I can get used to the technique and the whole process of it. And once I get a couple that are pretty good and I'm getting more consistent and I have my process more dialed in and I'm having like none of these bleed through areas and stuff, that's when I'll start diving into the more complex ones like the Straw Hat Pirates, for example. I do have another book video coming that is coming soon. I am like halfway through that book and I'm just going to keep chunking out best I can, so stay tuned for that. But yeah, thanks for watching and I really appreciate your time. Like, subscribe, comment down below if you have any suggestions. Those suggestions can even be like books to read, series to read, you know, or certain painting suggestions. At the start, please try and keep it simple if you do suggest something. However, if you do suggest something more complex, I'll try to get to it once my technique is better and I can kind of do the justice it deserves. But yeah, thanks for watching, everyone. I'll see you in the next one and have a good day.